You Our hearts were blind. another day. I'm not sure I can make
that you loved me. For this you're not to blame, because I'll tell you frankly, I thought I felt the same.
Thank you. Oh, Well, there's a man with a gun over there. He's telling me I've gotta be well. We gotta stop. Hey, what's that sound? Everybody look what's going round.
so far away. When I see you with it, I feel just like a fool. And I'm not trying to throw my love at you, but I think you should know. You blow me away, girl, but you're so far away. Show me the way to your heart, girl. My life is like a hopeless exercise, and when the day is done, I hang my head and cry. I close the lights, and when I close my my life, if I could have you for one night. When morning came, I'd gladly go and rest assured that you would know. You blow me away, girl, but you're so far away. Girl, won't you show me the way to your heart? Girl, you blow me away.
Sitting with Tom Nikosey and Mike Garrigan, two of the original members of Majic Ship. Now, from my early discussions with you guys, you had a mentor, and his name was Milt something.
Milt Schnapp. Mindy.
Mindy. How'd you get involved?
Actually, we were playing at a high school dance, and the proverbial guy in the shark skin suit walked in. A month later, we were signing a contract with the Tokens for Bright Tunes, the BT Puppy Records, and the record came out shortly after. So he actually was a man of his word.
I got a call from Mike then during the week, and he said, Gus, would you like to come down and audition for our group? And I said, sure, I'd love to. This is a great opportunity for me. So I came down to the Rob Buckman's house at the time. I came down, and Rob started hitting the drums. I started hitting the bass, and we got together, and I guess Rob must have said, yeah, he liked me. And a couple of days later, the guys called me, and I was very happy to join the group.
Nighttime Music was not the first recording, but it was the official first release that we did.
The first recording takes us back to the Primitives in 19, what would that be, Tom?
1966.
And the first thing we ever recorded was On the Edge, and then we didn't have a follow-up when they told us we could do a second song, so we played Mustang Sally, and I believe you folks are going to get to hear that demo from 1966.
Rob, what are your thoughts on Hummin? Some of the guys in the band thought it was a very orchestrated type of a song.
Well, you know, we didn't have the final say-so. We went in, we did some basic tracks, and then about, 2 months later, we got the record, and we went, whoa, what is this?
You covered a lot of BG tunes.
Well, we started actually playing Bee Gees tunes before Nighttime Music was presented to us as a song to be recorded. One of the strengths that the Majic Ship possessed, actually the Primitives and then the Majic Ship, was the vocals, and Mike brought that to the group.
Actually, I suffered from Bee Gees disease at the time. I still get it. I never know when it's going to
I think there's a great dichotomy that takes place when you hear the full CD, and that becomes evident when you go from the singles and transcend into the album material. We were almost forced to do the album stuff because we had had it with the popular tunes that our management at the time was trying to get us to record, the La 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 stuff, like Mike said before, and we wanted to break out of that and do more original stuff. And I think what you're hearing on the album is really what was coming from the heart. Yeah, Down by the River, for what it's worth, first of all, Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Neil Young were a big influence on our band. That was the transition period.
Right? It was also a time when lyrics were becoming more important and had something to say, and we felt we had something to say at the time. And if you listen to the album closely, you'll see a big difference from the early Majic Ship singles and the Pretty Boys and the bubblegum music to the revolution starting, actually.
Okay, Rob, I wanted to ask you a couple of questions. One in particular, you have credits, songwriting credits, on the song Too Much. What can you tell me about it? I mean, how did that song come about?
Well, basically, I didn't have the words, but I helped more in the production of it. And then let's make a break there, put a bridge in there. And
what was the song about?
You want to be, I'll be very honest with you.
Sure.
I do not remember. All I can do is look back and say, well, back then, yeah, everything was too much.
Gus, you had two songs on the LP, which came out in 1970, but one first and foremost was the song you wrote, which was called We Gotta Live On.
Well, on February 24th, 1970, I was telephoned, and I was told that my both parents were killed in a car accident. I decided to write down a little bit of what my feelings were feeling like in my heart. Now, I couldn't put down anything about my parents, so I kind of like turned it into a love song of losing a loved one. And the words kind of speak for themselves on how I feel, and that is, you look back and you say, what can I do?
Yeah.
And the answer is, you got to live on.
Okay, Phil, tell me a little bit about Sioux City Blues.
Okay, that was really, it came out about from experiencing Sioux City, the city there in Iowa. My father was stationed at an Air Force base there. There was another guitarist, a very good one, Tommy Bowen, that was from there, in a rival band. This is in the early 60s. And you got to remember, this was a time where the long hair was really not accepted back there. And we were constantly getting together. We hung around together, and we would always talk about how we wanted to get away from that particular area. You know, get someplace other with our music, and it was very difficult to be there in those days and try to establish music and the look that we wanted for that time. And that's really what the song reflects. Moving on.
I think we're really excited for everybody to hear the two new songs.
I've been writing songs pretty steadily. About a year and a half ago, we got back together, picked up some guitars, and started to sing, and looked at each other and knew that there was a reason that we had come back together.
The magic was still there, right?
The magic was still there, and since then we've written quite a few songs, and I hope you like the two new ones, and if you do, give us a call.
Yeah, there's more to come.
You guys all are still friends. You look back on those days, any regrets?
No, I have no regrets. We just